Hi, my name is Gülçin Batmaz. I'm a specialist solutions architect for Amazon Connect. In this video, I would like to tell you about Amazon Connect contact flows. A contact flow simplifies how you define a customer's experience with your contact center from the start to finish using an easy-to-use drag-and-drop interface. Contacts are routed through your contact center based on the routing logic that you define in your contact flows. Contact flows can play or show prompts to the user, get user inputs, and behave differently depending on the conditions. In a way, contact flows are like simple programs written in a very constrained visual programming language. Now, explore what the contact flow interface looks like. Now, let's go and build a simple contact flow and see how it works. Click this button, create a contact flow. Amazon Connect provides a contact flow editor that lets you drag and drop blocks onto the designer canvas. You can use connectors to connect blocks in the flow and then configure settings for each block after adding it into the designer. You can start by giving your contact flow a name and a description. Here you can see there are 5 categories, and if you expand each, you can see several activities called contact blocks. Contact blocks are the building blocks of your contact flows and are designed for a specific function. The entry point is the starting block when a customer calls the phone number. The first task we will perform is to set up logging. From the left menu, choose Set, then drag and drop the Set Logging Behavior block to the canvas. Verify logging behavior is set to enable the default. Amazon Connect is natively integrated with Amazon Polly to convert text into lifelike speech. With this block, you can set the text-to-speech language and voice to use for your contact flow. With the set recording block, you can select whether you want to record the call, and if so, whether you want to record both agent and client speaking or only one side. Next, we want to understand why a customer is calling or chatting with us. For this, we use the Get Customer Input block from the Interact blocks. It will deliver a message and then branch based on the input. It could be a DTMF key input or Amazon Lex intent. With Amazon Lex natively integrated with Amazon Connect, you can build conversational interactions that feel natural to your customers. For now, we will use DTMF entry. There are 2 types of user prompts. You can either upload an audio file or use text-to-speech engine. With text-to-speech, you can play a dynamic message where you can customize the prompt depending on various attributes. For example, instead of saying thank you for calling any company, you can customize it to say, hello John, thank you for calling company. This can be done by identifying the customer's phone number and looking up on a database to retrieve the name. For now, we will simply use a static welcome message. You can see it also has 3 additional options: timeout, error, and default. Next, we need to transfer the call to the appropriate queue. We first need to set the working queue before the transfer. Similarly, I will drop 2 more set working queue blocks, one for billing and another one for support. You might have different hours of operations for your queues, so we need to put a condition to check if the particular queue is within the hours of operation or not before the transfer to queue block. And this block will check if the current working queue is within the hours of operation or not. If it's within the hours, it will take the in-hours exit point. And if it's out of hours, it will take the out of hours path. And now we can transfer the queue. For this, we need to transfer to queue block from terminate and transfer. Next, we can connect the in-hours exit to transfer to queue block. Finally, we need to handle all these out of hours, timeout, default, and error exit points. So let's connect them to few play prompt blocks so that the customer will hear an appropriate message. Finally, we have the capacity point, which sets a limit for the queue. If the limit is exceeded, the contact flow will take the capacity path. In that case, you can place a message like, "Sorry, all our agents are busy. Please call back later." And the last step is to disconnect the call. And now the contact flow is ready and we can save and publish it in order for the changes to be reflected. Now that we have published the contact flow, let's go ahead and call the number that is claimed within your contact instance. I am going to sign in as an agent and set my status to available.
Thank you for calling any company. Please press 1 for sales, 2 for support, and 3 for billing.
In just a few minutes, we created an entire IVR using Amazon Connect. With Amazon Connect contact flows, you can create dynamic, data-driven, personalized flows by easily integrating with other systems such as CRM and databases. Amazon Connect contact flows integrate with Amazon Lex and can enable self-service interactions based on natural language understanding speech recognition. Amazon Connect's machine learning powered contact flows enable you to easily turn on and off capabilities that provide customers with a low effort experience, including agent intelligent routing, voice biometrics, customer profiles, and agent assist tools. I hope you enjoyed this demo. To learn more about Amazon Connect and contact flows, visit our website at aws.com/connect.